Back in the early days of PiNet, one of the most requested features was shared folders. Shared folders allow educators to distribute resources and activities, and also for students to work together in collaborative projects. To create a new shared folder, hit Create Shared Folder. It then shows a list of shared folders we've already got. In this case, I haven't got any. And I can now enter a name for my shared folder. I'm going to call it Resources. We then get the option of, do we want to set the folder as read-only or read-write for the students? Read-only works perfect for resources and activities, whereas read-write works perfect for collaborative projects together between students. In this case, I'm going to set it as read because I'm creating a resources folder. And that's it. It's now been created. I can navigate to that folder, home/shared/resources, by opening up the file manager, clicking computer, clicking home, shared, and resources. I can then create new documents here. In this case, I'm just going to create an empty document. I'm going to call it hello. And if we now switch over to the Raspberry Pi, if I click the file manager, on the left-hand side, you should see all your shared folders. In this case, the resources folder. Now there it is. There's the document I've already created. From the shared folders menu, you can also remove shared folders, change the permissions of shared folders for students, display a list of all your shared folders, or add new users to the teachers group, which allows them write access to all shared folders. One final thing worth noting with shared folders, you can edit them on the server or on the Raspberry Pi if logged in as a teacher. In this case, I'm logged in as a teacher, and I'm going to grab this screenshot I would like to share with my students. I'm going to copy it, and I'm going to paste it on here. And all my students can now access this screenshot via the shared folders.